Hi guys, thank you so much for watching The Royal We. My name is Kevin. In this video, I'm going to be talking about narcissism, obviously, but I'm also going to be talking about the church. More specifically, I'm going to be talking about narcissism inside the church. And you may be saying, wait a minute, what, Kevin, narcissism inside the church? Yes, absolutely. I'm going to be using three different biblical references that I believe are key to understanding not only how narcissism gets inside the church, but what you and I can do about it. So we're going to talk about this right here on The Royal We. Okay guys, I know you're probably saying church and narcissism, how can this be? Well, let's stop and consider first that church is oftentimes the largest accumulation of people at their most vulnerable place in life. We're talking about the hurt, the broken, people who are looking for guidance. This actually makes the church the biggest target for narcissism. Now, if you know the story of when Jesus told Peter, you are going to be the rock on which I'm going to build my church, he gave him three instructions, and these instructions are important for you and I to know. John 21:16 says, feed my sheep. Now, it's important to understand that Jesus referred to people in the church as sheep, right? Vulnerable. Feed the vulnerable. Teach the vulnerable. This was the instructions to Peter. Then he also followed that up with, tend to my sheep, tend to the vulnerable, take care of them, make sure they stay safe. What's a good shepherd do? Let's talk about this. A good shepherd feeds the sheep, not only feeds the sheep, but watches over them, protects them. We are so far from this in today's modern churches, because today's churches are number driven, and so oftentimes it's an open door policy. All are welcome, come on in, and that's okay. And most churches today say, shake the hand of someone who's next to you, and you have no idea whose hand you're shaking. But this is the policy. Get to know somebody, shake their hand. And obviously, when this happens, you allow bad elements inside the church. You can allow wolves to now come in and mix in with the sheep. Okay, so how can we identify these people who have crept inside of the church? How do we identify the wolves amongst the sheep? Well, fortunately, it's actually written in the Bible. It's in the book of Jude. Now, I'm not going to read the entire book of Jude to you. I encourage you to read this for yourself, but I'm going to outline what Jude does say about these people, about what to look out for in the church. Here's how you identify them. One, they pervert the grace of God. They pervert the grace of God. How many of you have come across somebody in church who cusses and calls people names and then says, I'm forgiven. You're not perfect. Right? Or how about this, if your dating starts to take you out and then starts to pressure you to have sex? God made us this way. We're forgiven. We're covered by His grace. This is perverting the grace of God, and you have to watch out for this. These are serious red flags of wolves that are inside of the church. Next one, they reject authority. They do not understand boundaries. Boundaries make them upset. This goes into the next thing that Jude points out. Like irrational animals, he says, they do whatever instincts tell them to do. Now, I've already made a video once before about the difference between wisdom and emotions, and I talk about instincts in this video. I'll put a link right here. It's a great one to watch after you're done watching this one. Now, instincts. Animals operate off of instincts only. Jude makes the comparison of these people, these narcissists, to animals that operate off of instincts. Then Jude says they're grumblers and they're fault finders. Once again, this is typical narcissist behavior. Grumblers, grumble, grumble, grumble. They're always pointing out people's flaws. They're always angry about how something was said. They're fault finders. Everything could be good, but they're going to point out the things that are bad about the church or about the people in the church. They're going to be gossiping, lots of gossip in the church. Oh, look at so-and-so, or so-and-so thinks they're better. So-and-so isn't living right. Gossipers and fault finders. This is another red flag of a wolf. That's what they do. They find fault with people. He also points out they boast about themselves. Boast about themselves. There's a lot of that going on in the church. I'm this and I'm that, and I'm head over this ministry and I'm head over that ministry. Constantly boasting. The last one that Jude talks about is flattering others for their own advantage to get what they want. Now, this is what narcissists do, what Jude has outlined here for us. He has described all their traits and all their characteristics. This is what you and I deal with when we deal with narcissists. And what's interesting is he's talking about this being in the church. So yes, it's in the church. Now, Jude does not go into great detail on how to deal with these individuals. He acknowledges that they're there, and his point is for you and me to be careful. His resolve in the situation is to say, it's okay to have mercy on people, right? With caution. That's his whole point about bringing this up and bringing up these characteristics. He's saying, be cautious. Look for these things. Look at these red flags. Be merciful towards people, but use it with caution. Be cautious. What does this mean? This means you can be nice to somebody, but when you feel yourself starting to be lured, just say no. Be very careful. This is what it's all about. You see, we can't kick out all of the narcissists out of church, right? But we can protect ourselves. This is why Jude wrote that. Now, there's also another scripture, the last scripture I want to point out to you. This is how to deal with an individual who is really harassing you and really giving you a hard time at church. This can be found in the book of Matthew. Matthew 18:15 talks about this. Matthew 18:15 says, confront a person who is offending you, who is harassing you, confront them. And it goes on to say this, if the person doesn't listen, if the narcissist isn't listening, then bring two or more others with you from the church and confront them together. Confront the narcissist together. And it says, if the narcissist still doesn't listen, then bring the elders of the church to confront the narcissist. And if the narcissist still doesn't listen, then it says, finally, treat that individual like you would a pagan. Again, like Jude said, you would have mercy, but you'd be very cautious. Don't associate with them. Don't go out with them. Don't have private time with them. You see, guys, the problem, what we're learning about narcissistic abuse is that, yes, narcissists exist. This evil exists. But the real problem is when you and I get lured into it. We miss the red flags. We take the flattery. We ignore the fact that they're grumbling, that they're complaining. We ignore the fact that they are perverting the grace of God. That they say, oh, no, let's have sex. It's okay to have sex. God will forgive us. You want it too. We ignore these things. And then we wonder why it is that we feel stuck, ravaged by this wolf in life who has destroyed us and taken everything. This is why. It's written right there. For those of you who go to church, it's written right there. Again, guys, we cannot get rid of narcissists. We can't get rid of narcissists in our neighborhood. We cannot get rid of narcissists at work. You cannot get rid of narcissists from within your own church. But what you can do is protect yourself, develop your own set of values, your own boundaries, and stay away. Don't associate with them. Beyond having mercy. You can have mercy, you can pray for people, but don't associate with them deeper than that. And be very careful who you let into the intimate space of your life. This is what boundaries are all about. This is what Jude talks about. All right, guys? Thank you so much for watching. Hi, guys.
Thank you for watching the Royal We.
Yes, thank you for watching the Royal We. I want to let you guys know that I am almost finished with the course. It's going to be available pretty soon, and I'm excited to be able to offer that to you guys. I also want to let you guys know that I'm thankful for all of your phone calls. You can continue to contact me. It's absolutely free. But for those of you who have demanded that you be able to give back in return, I want to let you know that I have put a donation link on my channel. So you're welcome to donate whatever you would like to donate to this channel. And you don't have to. That's completely up to you. Bless you guys. Thank you. Be sure to hit that like and subscribe button if you're not already a subscriber. And we will be back with more right here on the Royal We. While you look at the camera, you gotta stay looking at the camera, okay?
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Guys, I'll say hi and then you say hi. No, no, no finger in the nose. You gotta be professional.
One, two, three. Hi, guys.